हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू सेलेनियम वेब ड्राइवर ट्रेनिंग सेशन 23। दिस इज हरदन वन सेकंड एज यूजुअल। टुडे आई विल शो यू हाउ वी कैन परफॉर्म टेस्ट एग्जीक्यूशन विद द हेल्प ऑफ हेडलेस ब्राउजर्स यूजिंग क्रोम ड्राइवर, फायरफॉक्स ड्राइवर एज वेल एज HTML यूनिट ड्राइवर। थैंक यू ऑल फॉर वॉचिंग माई वीडियोज। इन केस यू आर एंजॉइंग माई वीडियोज and learning automation testing and Java, please like and share my videos. Do not forget to subscribe my channel and press the bell icon so that you will get notification as and when I will upload any new videos. Do not forget to provide your valuable comment for any input or suggestion. Stay tuned for my next videos. What is headless browser testing? So whenever you want to perform test execution of any web applications without opening a browser, it is termed or called as headless browser testing. Normally what happens whenever we are doing the test execution with the help of iBrowsers, Chrome browsers or Firefox browser, right? We used to set the path and we used to set the properties for the Chrome or Firefox or iDriver, right? So that like browser will be launched and whatever options we want to perform, so browser will launch and after the URL open, right? And also like whatever field you want to identify, after identification whatever action you want to perform, it will be displayed and you can see the executions, so that it will launch the web page and execution will be performed step by step. You can visually see it. But the headless browser acts similar to the normal web browsers. User have full control over the web page loaded into the headless browsers. The only difference is that user will not able to see a graphical user interface. So whenever you are doing any testing with the headless browser, so you will not able to see the navigation part. So that is the difference between the normal testing with the headless browser testing. Okay. User have no option other than using headless testing when user machine does not have a GUI. For instance, if the user want to run test in Unix, right? So if, I mean, here in case there is no GUI is there, right? So we can, I mean, it is recommended to use the headless browsers testing. It is recommended to use the headless browsers when tests are executed in parallel, as user interface based browser consumes a lot of memory resources. So headless browser can be used for server side performance testing too. Whenever we are launching the browser, right, it will take some memory or resources, but during the headless browser, as it will not launch any browser, so it will memory or resources allocations will be less in the headless browser testing. Anyone can run test case using headless browsers, then user will get the result just in seconds. User, when tester have to run the test case on the remote machine or servers, which does not have any browsers, but still user have to execute the test case, then we prefer with the headless browser testing. So headless browser testing is very fast also compared to normal testing. Headless browser, if you go with the headless browser testing, it will take less time. Suppose in the if you want to launch, right, and if you want to perform all the operations, suppose it's take 1 minute, but it is observed that headless browser testing, it's take like more less than 50% of that time. So obviously time can be reduced, execution time can be reduced with the help of headless browser testing. Some of the example of the headless browser testing included, like we can use HTML unit drivers, Ghost driver, Phantom JS, Chrome driver, Firefox driver, Zombie JS or OTA web driver. So that is the important driver with the help of which we can do the headless browser testing. So I will show you how we can perform the headless browser testing with the Chrome and Firefox first. After that I will show you what with the help of HTML unit driver. So here I have already created a class headless browser testing. First you need to set the properties. Suppose if I want to do the with the Chrome browser, we need to set the properties for the Chrome driver, right? Then we need to use that options of Chrome options or Firefox option. You need to use it for the perspective of the browsers, right? Once you that use that Chrome browsers, you need to with the help of Chrome options class, you need to create an object for instance, right? Then also you need to create a new object. For instance, suppose I am giving the name as option or option. Okay. And here you can see some error messages coming. You need to import, right, Chrome option class from the org.openqa.selenium.chrome package. Once the import is successfully, you need to use that particular object and if you press dot, and then you need to use dot set headless, right? Dot set headless. Then you need to give some boolean value because it will be headless. So you need to give it to true, right? Then you need to set the right web driver. You need to use the web driver interface and Chrome driver class, right? That you are launching the initiating the driver, right? Object, right? So web driver is the interface, we need to use it for Chrome browsers, right? So you need to import the web driver interface from the org.openqlot.selenium, and also you need to import Chrome driver class from the here. You need to use that option because we have given the object name for the Chrome option is option, right? And you need to import it, the Chrome driver from the org.openqlot.selenium.chrome, right? Once the import is successful, the whatever drivers object we have created, right, we can use the same object, the similar after the similar approach. Dot get, we need to pass an URL. Suppose I want to pass URL for Facebook, say I want to launch the Facebook. You need to pass the URL for Facebook, right? Once the URL is launched, suppose if you want to perform some operation, it will, you can perform it, right? Suppose I want to highlight that element, I want to pass some information here, okay, in the email field, right? So how you, in first you need to inspect the element, you need to press F12 button from the keyboard, and you need to find the use the inspect element, and after that you need to find the properties for the email or phone field, right? You can see some of the unique properties coming, right? Name equal to email, right? So I will be creating an web element, okay. Element, and here it is the name as email, right? Email. And I can identify with the help of name driver dot find element by dot name. And I need to simply pass the name, right? And you can see some error message is coming. You need to import the web element class from the org.openqlot.selenium, and after that, whatever. Right, object we are creating for the web element, for the name email field, we with the help of that object or instance, I can send keys, right? I can enter some value. Suppose I want to enter the value as test@test.com. Okay. Now, if you want to validate, if you want to print it out the value, because right now you will not able to see if the execution is successful or not, right? So you need to use the SOISO methods, right? And you need to use the object, for instance, whatever you created, dot get attribute and value. So in case it is text field which is editable, so you can, you can't use the get text method, you need to use the get attribute method where you can get the value whatever you have entered. And after that, if you want to get the title, right, you can get it, title of the page, right? Driver dot get title, right? And if you want to get the current URL of the page, you can also get it. Driver dot get current URL, right? So I am going to close with semicolon. Here you need to give one bracket, so it will be working fine. So you need to first set the properties for the Chrome drivers. After that, you need to use the Chrome option class and need to create an object or instance, okay. Once the object is created, you need to set headless, because obviously we are not going to launch the browsers, it will be headless. You need to pass the boolean parameters true. Then you need to create a drivers object or instance with the help of web driver interface and the Chrome driver class, where you need to give the object reference for the Chrome options, right? And after that, you need to pass the URLs and whatever. You need to identify the element. Suppose email, I want to add some values, enter some value with the help of send this key method. After that, I want to print it out, right? Whatever value I have entered, right, in the email field, test@test.com, it will be printed out. And also I want to get the title, so title will be right, Facebook, right, login or sign up, and the current URL will be that same thing, https://www.facebook.com. If you run it, you can see no web page, no browser or window will open, but execution will be there, okay? And at the end of the execution, successful, right? and after that we can close the quit the divert, divert dot close, right? Whatever you need, only one divert is open, so I can close it instead of quitting. So let's run the code and let's see that no browser will be launched because it is headless browser testing, right? But execution will be done, and in case it is getting failed or passed, so output will be displayed. In getting failed also, it will throw some error, and the execution will be fast comparative to whenever we want to launch the browsers. So that is the main advantage. So whenever in any machines, right, there is no browser available, we can use the headless browsers, and so that there is no required to launch the browser, but we can get the expected result. Okay, so here we have entered the value in the email field as test@test.com, and here you can, with the help of get attribute method, we can get the value, right? And here we can get the title, right? Facebook login or sign up, that is the title, right? So here you already seen no browser is getting launched, and also the current URL www.facebook, we can get it and we can close the browsers, right? So that's way we can execute the test case. Okay, now let's move it to remove that HTTPS part. So obviously my test case will fail, right? If you run the code again, you can say though browser will not launch, but test case will be failed, and it will throw some the exact error message in the consoles, right? So that is the important. That's why when in the for the failed test case, the object is not able to identify, it will still be displayed, right? Here you can see some error message already came, though it is not opening the browsers, right? Here you can see the error message is coming as, right, invalid argument, right? Because the argument whatever you are giving, it is not in argument is not correct, right? That Facebook page is not correct because you need to give the HTTPS. Okay, so again if you change it to the same part HTTPS, and here if I want to identify the element, suppose instead of element give some different value which is not visible at all in the page, again it will throw some error, it will not able to identify the element, so it will obviously give some error message. So you can see here after opening the Facebook, though it is not launching the browser, so it will perform all the steps and it will throw some error message because it will not able to identify the element with the help of name whatever we have entered, email 455, because only email is the valid thing, right? And you can see some error message is coming, and it is not, in case anything is failing, obviously it will not execute to the remaining step. Here the error message is coming that you can see no such element found, right? No such element exception is coming, right? Name equal to email 1455, right? So that's why also we can do the execution. Now I will show you the similar approach with the help of Firefox driver. So you need to first set the property for the Firefox driver. I'm just copying paste the same thing. So first you need to set the properties for the Firefox driver or Gecko driver for the Firefox browser. Then here, as it is Firefox, instead of Chrome option, you need to use the Firefox options. Okay, and you need to create an object or instance, suppose options. Okay, and you need to use the same Firefox option for creating a new object or instance. Here some error message is coming because you need to set the, import the Firefox option from the org.openq.selenium.firefox packages, right? After that, with the help of options object, we need to set headless, it will be true, and after that we need to create instantiate the Firefox browser, right? So that we need to create a driver for the web driver interface with the help of Firefox driver class. We need to import Firefox driver from org.openq.selenium.firefox, and also I already web driver is there, that is the reason, so no need to import it. You can see web driver already there. After that, again similar code I will just copy paste, right? After your driver is long instance initiated, right, we can pass the URL for Facebook, right? We can get any URL Facebook. Suppose I am using the same URL and I am identifying the element with the help of email as which is the name, right? name property was email for the particular field, or maybe I can identify the password field. I will identify the different field, password. Okay, so here name is pass. So I will identify with the help of pass. Okay, it will be password. Okay, here I can use the same password field, and also I can get the attribute, right? So the password I am giving as test 1 2 3 4 5 6, like that. Okay, and also I want to get the value, I want to get the title of the current URL and the title. So after that I want to close it. Okay, so if you run it, so here also no browsers navigation will be displayed. Instead of that, it will give you the result, because it is a headless browser testing, right? For the Firefox browsers, with the help of GeoDiver and with the help of Firefox options class and with the help of set headless methods, right? So it will launch the Firefox browser. After that, it will pass the URL for Facebook. It will try to identify. Okay, and you can see that, it is coming, right? It will try to identify the password field, right? Web element with the help of name, which is the pass. After that, it will try to send the keys test 1 2 3. Then here it will get the, you can get the value with the help of get attribute class for the password field whatever is entered, and you can get the title, you can get the current URL. After that, it will close the browser. So here you can see it's already come, right? Test 1 2 3, whatever password was entered, right, that is the title, get title, Facebook login or sign up, and that is the current URL, right? Now similar way, if you change the properties for the password field, right, name, so it will throw some error. If you run it now, though it is not launching the Chrome browsers, but it will execute, okay, because it is a headless browser testing, but it will fail it, right? Because it will not able to identify the password field with the name already provided, pass 2 3 3 4, because it is not valid one, right? So it will fail and it will not execute the remaining step. It will not give you the get title and as well as the current URL, also the value, because it will fail, right? You can see some error message came, right? Error message is that unable to locate element name equal to pass 2 3 3 4, that is the reason it is failing and it is not able to proceed the next step. Obviously, you know, whenever it's failing in the next step, in any step, until you are expecting some exception, you are not handling the exception, obviously it will not proceed to the next step. So obviously that is the reason the next step, you are, thing is not getting displayed, right, in my consoles. So that's why you can also, right, do the headless browser testing with the help of GeoDiver or Chrome browsers. Okay, so with the help of HTML unit driver, Ghost and Phantom JS, Chrome, Firefox, Zombie JS, OTR web driver, with the help of this browser, we can do the headless drivers, headless browser testing. Now, HTML unit driver is the very important driver whenever we want to perform the headless browser testing. In case no browser is available in any of the systems, right, and your computer or remote desktop, right, you can use the HTML unit driver. So HTML unit driver is the most lightweight and fastest implementation headless browser for web driver. Suppose in case it is using the Chrome driver, it is taking 20 seconds, right? But whenever it is using the HTML unit driver, it will take less than 10 seconds. So that is the very fastest, because it is a lightweight, right, and fastest implementation. It is based on HTML unit. It is known as headless browser driver. It is same as Chrome IE or Firefox driver, but it does not have any GUI. Okay, so that is the reason there is no need to set the properties for the HTML unit driver. That is the one major advantage. Only you need to launch it, right? You need to create a object, instancing, create a object, right, for the HTML unit driver with the help of web driver interface, right, for that class. After that, you can use it. No need to set the properties, or no need to, right, use that particular Chrome options or Firefox option like that. Okay, also set headless driver, you no need to, simply just you need to instance in a driver object, okay, with the help of web driver interface and with the help of HTML unit driver. So why we prefer HTML unit driver for the headless browser testing? It supports for HTTPS and HTTPS protocols. It supports HTML responses. It can click link submitting form, right? Working the DOM model of the HTML document, etc. Support for cookies. Proxy server support is also provided by the HTML unit drivers. Excellent JavaScript support. It can be useful to customize the request header being sent to the servers. It has also the ability to determine whether failing response from the servers should throw exceptions or should be returned as page of the appropriate type. Okay, so now I will show you how we can instance injected driver for the HTML unit drivers. Okay, just simply you need to use that option. Web driver, and you need to create a driver object instance with the help of HTML unit driver. So if you use it, so your driver will be instantiated. Okay, you can see some error message is coming because you need to import HTML unit driver. So before that, you need to first install HTML unit driver. So you can go to the site github.selenium/seleniumhq HTML unit hyphen driver, and you can write go for any drivers. What are the latest release? So I already downloaded HTML unit driver, okay, 2.40.0. Okay, and here before using that particular syntax, you need to import that particular jar file in your project. So here I have in my Selenium training project. If you right click, so if there is a option called property, you can go to the properties, right? And here if you go to the library, so let's remove it. I can remove that particular part. Okay, once you remove it, right, if you apply and close, you can see here if you use that particular term, right, web driver driver equal to HTML new unit driver, and if you click on the error message button, so here you will not get the option to launch the HTML unit driver because that particular jar file is not added to a project. Here some option is providing, right, create class HTML unit driver, change it to web driver, like that, right? So you need to first download it from the particular site. After the download is successful, you need to go to the project properties, and you need to click on the add external jars, right? And here if you already downloaded it, so it will be available in downloaded folder. So here it is the version 2.40 HTML unit driver. So you need to import it in the project, right? Once you import you successfully, you need to apply and close. So it will be imported. Now if you click on the error message, it will give you the option to import the HTML unit drivers, right, which was not originally there because, right, that particular driver was jar file was not uploaded in my project. So right now you can see, right, apart from that, the other options, import HTML unit driver from org.openq.selenium.html unit is coming. So you need to simply use that, right? After that, if you want to launch a browser, you can simply use it. Okay, and you can get the title, right? So you need to use SYSO if you want to see whether it is correctly working fine or not. Driver dot get title, right? Similar way, you can get the current URL. You can perform any operations, right? Like that. Suppose if I want to perform the operations, and I can get the value, you can also get it. Okay, here you need to simply change it to pass only because my value was name was pass. Also, if you want to highlight that particular element with the help of ID, you can also do it, right? ID is also pass. So if you need to change it by name to ID, so it will also work by dot ID. Okay, it will also work because ID is also pass here, right? You can see ID is also pass, right? Suppose whatever value you are entering, suppose stays password. I just entering the value as password. Password 123. Okay, or password at the rate 123. And I want to get the value, and I want to also get the title, right? So it will open the HTML. It will launch the browsers. Though it is headless browser, obviously it will go to the URL and it will try to identify the password field, right? And it will enter the password @123 and you can get it in the console, and also in the you can get the title of the Facebook page. So you can see, if you run it, it will be run very fast. It will take only few seconds. Okay, so that is the reason we should use the HTML unit driver for the headless browser testing. Okay, and it in the console it will, you can get the expected thing, right? You can see it is coming, right? Password 123, whatever we have sent for the password field, the value is coming, also the title is coming, right? Facebook login or sign up page, because that is the title, right? Facebook login or sign up page, right? So that's why, with the help of any of the browsers mentioned here, any of the driver mentioned here, HTML unit, Ghost, PhantomJS, Chrome, Firefox, ZombieJS, WebTier, WebDriver, you can do the headless browser testing. So difference is that whenever you are referring for the headless browser, no browser will be launched, but you can perform any kind of operation. Similar way, now if you want to change it, like that password, something like that, obviously it will not be identifiable and it will throw some error. Let's run the code and let's see whether error message is triggered or not. Though it is not launching the browser, it will obviously throw some exceptions, that like no such element was found for the password field, because the ID is whatever you have provided is not available for the password field, right? So it will throw the error and it will not able to proceed to the next step. It will not give you the value as well as it not give you the title, right? Here you can see some exceptions came. You can see, like Selenium, no such element exception is fine, unable to locate with ID equal to that. Pass 123, like 24225, right? Okay, so that's why you can, without launching the browser, you can, perform the testing with the help of headless browser. Okay, that's all for today's session. Thank you.